Hi guys, I'm back out again for another wild camp. This time I'm in quite a familiar spot. You probably recognise it. And I'm out with these two cats. You probably recognise Man Camper. And that's Jonathan. You probably recognise him off, was it One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest or something? No, it was Man Camper's video of Blind Tarn, wasn't it? We'll have a look at Jonathan's setup there. He's got his stove. Oh, he looks like he's fully kitted out. He's got about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 torches.
He's got a torch fetish.
I do have a torch fetish. Well, basically, this is my favourite one. It's called a slide. It's one of the most powerful torches I've ever had. I believe you can burn cardboard with it if you hold it close.
Yeah.
Is it almost like a laser, is it?
Yeah,
brightness.
Yeah. You can feel when you turn it on.
It's pretty intense.
Aye.
It's warm.
Yeah.
That'll be handy for later. You know, like trying to lower down the Space Brothers, the extraterrestrials.
Yeah, we've got a
and
set
then,
like.
Obviously, you've got that as well. As a work light, magnetic. That's my main torch. Then I've got this one. I only get this one because it's quite handy. You shove it in your top pocket and you can. You know what I mean? You've got that.
It's like your hands on a torch if you just want something quick to grab.
Then, of course, everybody has a head torch. I've just got a petrol.
Yeah. That's the same one I've got.
They're quite good.
Yeah, kind of going far wrong with petrol.
Batteries last a long time in them. And then these guys here, these are different colours. These are for zooming in if you want to see something. These are different colours. You've got different colours, and if you look on this top there, look.
Oh yeah.
You can see the
creep. Well, that's and they're relatively cheap torches, aren't they?
Yeah,
but they're really.
Yeah. But you can zoom right in with them, look, and you've got different colours, and you can really like.
Very good.
And that's in the daylight. That's called bright.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You'll see it at night anyway.
I mean, you'll be bright, that lake.
You'll zoom in on anything across that field.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is Jonathan's setup in here. He just opens the flap for us.
Oh, hang on.
But he's held that before.
And I'm in that thing there. I was going to make an A-frame type shelter with hazel, but I thought, what's the point of cutting more wood down when I've got a tree I can just run a guy line off? And what I've done is I put a loop in the end of the cordage and just ran the other end through. And I've got it running down here to a prusik knot. And I've pushed it through the eyelet and I've put a toggle in. But because the guy line is staked to the ground, it's a bit low at that end, so I had to raise it slightly. So I've got a couple of foot length of hazel and I've attached it, so just to give it a bit more height. But you can see there the eyelet starting to, well, it was on its way out anyway. So I used the two existing eyelids either side to kind of take the strain off the end eyelet. So I've got plenty of room to lie under there. I could raise it up, I could put an upright to give us a bit more like sitting room, but I'm not gonna be sitting up. I'm just gonna, once I'm in there, I'm just gonna be lying down, I'll be going to sleep. We'll have a look at Man Camper set up there. He's more or less the same as me, he's in his British Army bivvy. Only difference is he's got his mattress on the bottom, whereas I've got mine in the sleeping bed in the bivvy. Only problem with that is it's just a bit of a tight fit. I've got a really thick downfill sleeping bag, which is good to go down to -6 Celsius. And if I was to use that with my bivvy and the mat inside, it would just compress it down and I would get a cool night's sleep. But I'm in a synthetic bag, so it doesn't really take up that much space and it doesn't matter too much if it gets compressed. So having it inside the bag, I think it's going to keep me a little bit warmer. So for now, we're just going to finish getting stuff sorted. Perhaps chop a few more logs. Paul's already made a start splitting some of the wood. It's bone dry in the middle as well, so it should be easy to get a fire going. This is where it's at, guys. Get out and do a bit of wild camping. You know it makes sense. You know it makes sense. And he's all hat.
I've got plenty of hats. but I'm just one big hack.
Squeal like a pig, boy.
You got a pretty mouth there, boy.
Get your ass up there and grab them wood, boy.
I haven't eaten all day, I skipped breakfast, and it's going to be a while before I light the fire, so I'm going to use that buddy burner. It'll burn for about 5 minutes, heat that water, and just have some 3 minute noodles.
It's nuts. The most nuts bar in anyone's house.
Well, this is what it's all about, just getting out here in the woods. And that's the 28th of December, and you're probably saying to yourself, you know, why aren't you at home and spending time Christmas and what have you, but we've done that. Christmas Day was just absolute bedlam. Just kids and, you know, so this is my little bit of escapism.
I think I put a bit too much water in there. Because they're beef noodles, I might stick a little bit of beef jerky in there, let it soften up, see what that's like.
Beef jerky?
It turns a snack into a bit of a meal lane because it swells up and it rehydrates. A nice, quick, easy meal in the woods.
If you build it up like this, it keeps it more contained and you can actually have a fire.
Yeah.
Like if you're wild camping on a bank like that and you haven't got much space and you think the because when it gets out of control, it can just roll away and it just goes on like this. It builds up like that and it just keeps it under control.
It's a square fire.
Keeps it.
Don't be square.
And it's almost a platform as well where you can put your pots and that on.
Aye. It's quite a lot of heat inside, although you kind of see it, I reckon that's, you know.
And the beauty with that is, it's drying the wood that's surrounding it as well.
Mm-hmm. That, you can kick that and it's not going to fall over.
You're quite clued up, you, aren't you?
No.
I knew that was a reason why. I knew deep in my heart that you would be a great, you'd be an asset to this wild camping adventure.
Like a makeshift barbecue, isn't it?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
That's how it is, isn't it?
That's how it is.
That's definitely where it's at.
Oh, them juices just oozing through there.
Quarter pounders.
Very nice.
Took it to them in about 10 minutes.
Moist. A moist muff. Muffin.
I like a moist muffin, like.
I do as well.
Yeah. Getting in my eyes.
Right, how are these shit on the sticks doing?
They smell quite nice considering that they came up my backside.
Sweet corn. Why did you have to eat sweet corn the night before?
Aye.
Alright, good.
Shit on a stick.
Shit on a stick. Because you know it makes sense.
It's all about recycling, yes.
Oh God, it hits you after a while, doesn't it?
Yeah, quite spicy. You'll have ring sting with that in the morning.
So when these steaks are done.
These are steaks, mate.
Again, straight in there.
And they are
marinated.
Mediumly done.
They're cooked very quickly as well with them being
thin. That's what I mean, because they've been very thin. So they are actually cooked to medium.
Yeah.
So I don't want to cook them any further to be like bits of leather.
You can tell he's done this before, you know.
Yeah, he's been used to
time soaked.
Putting his meat into a bag. Yeah, it's starting to steam up there already. Yeah, he's getting another one knocked there.
Cook with Fanny, eh?
Yeah. I've never ever seen this being done on a wild camp before.
On a barbecue?
On a barbecue, I haven't.
Well, yeah, it's the first for everything, eh?
It's the first for me.
Brilliant, man. It's where it's at. Mm-hmm. You should be on the telly, you know. Well, you're all on YouTube.
You can feel the pressure building up in the bag now because of the heat.
Yeah, it'll burst in a minute.
It might burst.
Yeah.
You've got your Jamie Oliver. You've got that other knobhead, what do you call him? Hugh Fernley Whittenstall. You know, cook on the wild side geezer. But this is where it's at, like.
It's bubbling, look there, look. It's boiling in the bag. That's why you've got to keep turning it over, because otherwise it'll just do on
one side.
Would you rather be sat at home watching shitty soaps, eating mince pies until you're sick in the face,
or come out here and just eat?
Out here eating proper food like that? No way, I would rather
on a continuous basis. Yeah. We've been eating since about 12 o'clock.
We've been eating and drinking, and this is a proper Christmas wildcat.
3.5 hours and we've been
now in. It's like in this place right as a pencil.
Christmas Day in Pegswood, and the goose is on the dole. And that's no good to anyone, neither body, mind, nor soul. The only thing he's gonna get is things stuffed up his hole. He wished it wasn't Christmas at all.
Christmas bollocks,
Christmas bollocks,
Christmas bollocks,
Christmas bollocks.
Bollocks, as I'm sure you will agree.
No, you will agree.
Christmas bollocks,
Christmas bollocks,
Christmas bollocks,
Christmas bollocks.
Christmas bollocks. It's our fucking bollocks to me.
Barbecue's finished. The fire's very low. We didn't want the fire too high anyway for cooking because it's burning some meat, so we're chopping some wood and we're just gonna get it going again, and it'll be a fire to keep warm and cook some stew later. Ah, that's definitely where it's at.
Oh yeah, a real, you can't beat a real fire, eh?
That was excellent, that. It sounded a bit like Zebedee towards the end.
Zebedee.
Aye. And Dr. Stephen Hawkins, wasn't it?
I hear Austin under the mysteries of the universe. We are the dog, little light dog, light dog.
Get up and do a bit of wild camping. You know it makes sense.
It makes lots of sense. You've got the Asherton Yeti, the Guidepost Yeti,
Northumbria, Achieve It Yeti, Morpeth Yeti.
Yeah. Just all over the place, really, aren't they?
We'll have to think of something new for Jonathan there.
Yeah. TT. Where, the TT Yeti.
DP?
TC Twit Yeti.
Double Penetration Yeti.
Yeti just sits there and takes it all in.
And he doesn't mind waking up with a tenner in his back pocket.
He's so boss.
I thought Yetis
were... We've all been there, Damien, haven't we?
I thought Yetis were givers, not receivers. Oh, yeah. Typhoon Interlude, I think. Bushcraft Kelly.
A bit interlude.
We'll get rang off somebody, you know what I mean? That looks fantastic, that.
Get some of the meat from the bottom. Actually, that.
That was good, that. Morning. Well, I've woken up bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, but I've got to be away sharp because these guys want to be away sharp. But I'm pleased I did get up sharp because it's just a beautiful morning. I heard a few strange noises last night as well, like an owl, fox, and possibly bird of prey. There might even been one or two yetis, but or could have been one of the lads snoring. But brilliant night, what can I say? Woke up a couple of times as well. I was sliding downhill, but that's probably because I was on a hill and I didn't really have a flat spot, which it's very hard to find a flat spot here. Jonathan took up the best spot with his tent because he's got a bigger footprint. With me being just in a bivvy, you know, I took like the second best spot because I didn't need as much space, if you know what I mean. So I'm not going to waffle too much, guys, because the lads need to be away. So we're all packed up, ready to go. And then hopefully we'll see you all on the next one. Have you got anything to say, lads, about the camp?
Not really, just get out and try a little bit of wild camp, because you know it.
It makes sense. It's no good being an armchair wild camper. You've just got to get up there and do it. And hopefully, by us doing it, it'll inspire you guys to get up there and do it. So. There you go.
This is where it's at.
This is where it's at. Get up and do a bit of wild camping to you. You know it makes sense.
remember to leave no trace, and that means coming back for the camera.